Learning data science is one of the best decisions you can make. These skills open you up to a ton of new opportunities and high-paying jobs in a rapidly growing field. Data is everywhere, and companies need people with these skills to make data useful. If you're a beginner, you can actually learn these things for a very low cost online. Don't get me wrong, a degree will certainly be very helpful to get a job, but it's not the only way. Now, a great platform to learn all of these skills is Coursera, because they offer high-quality courses from top universities and companies for a low monthly fee, or even for free if you use financial aid. You also get certificates that you can add to your LinkedIn profile. In this video, I'm going to cover their top 8 data science courses. So let's get started. First on the list, we have Applied Data Science with Python. Now, data science is a very popular field right now because data fuels everything from companies to their decision making to chatbots like ChatGPT, Bard, and so on. They're all trained on data. And Python is a skill in very high demand for data science. So learning Python specifically for this will set you up for a ton of opportunities. Now, the course itself has a 4.5 rating and is an intermediate level course with no prior experience or any programming or anything required before. And yes, it does sound a little bit strange because it is a course for beginners, also an intermediate level course, right? All that it means is that if you compare it to some of the other courses on Coursera, specifically for data science, it's going to be a little bit more challenging than the normal beginner courses. Also very rewarding. Now, it takes about 4 months at 10 hours per week, and the schedule is flexible, so you can take it as fast as you want. There are 5 courses in this specialization. The first one is an introduction to data science in Python. Next, we have applied plotting, sharding, and data representation in Python. Then we have applied machine learning in Python and text mining in Python. And finally, applied social networking analysis in Python. Now, what about the pros and cons? Well, I think it's a really great course with a solid rating of 4.5 stars. University of Michigan is a well-established university. I've taken courses from them myself on Coursera, and they wouldn't risk all of their reputation on a bad course. Because it's on Coursera, it's also affordable, and financial aid is available for those who need it. But the best thing is to focus on application in this course. It's not just about learning abstract concepts, but rather on doing and applying. The main issue that I see is that if you're looking for a role towards data analytics, it's not going to be the best course for you. But the next course definitely is. Number 2, the Google Data Analytics Certificate. And it's a very popular and well-known course, so I'm not going to talk that much about it, but I still need to mention it. It has 4.8 stars, 6 months at 10 hours per week, and nearly 2 million people enrolled. The courses in this program are structured according to the data analytics lifecycle. So you start by asking questions, preparing data, processing data, analyzing, sharing data, and also some programming in R on the side and a final capstone project. The pros of this course is how accessible it is for beginners. It's also a very well-known course and a nice introduction to the field. The downsides are that it's not the most practical course. It's very beginner level and very theoretical, and you'll learn R instead of Python. But next up, I have something that I think is even better. And we have the Advanced Google Data Analytics Certificate. And before we get into all the more advanced courses, let's just cover this one. Now, this is an extension of the original data analytics course, but in this one, you'll work a lot with Python instead. And that's a huge plus. Now, it says advanced level, but really, it just means a level above the original course. It's not an advanced course by any means. A beginner can still take this, but I still recommend that you take the first course first, but you can take it without taking the first course, if that makes sense. It's also 6 months, 10 hours per week, slightly more focused on other data science skills, not just the classic tasks of a data analyst. The first course is Foundations. Course 2 is about Introduction to Python, and then about translating data into insights. Course 4 about statistics, and then regression analysis. And next, you learn about machine learning for 37 hours. So you will be able to learn quite a bit. Of course, not go super in depth because you don't really have that foundation. And at last, you'll have a capstone project. The good thing about this course is that it's very general and focusing on a lot of different data science skills, while still focusing on data analytics mainly. It also includes a ton of Python. Now, the big downside is that there's going to be no SQL in this course at all, unfortunately, which is a shame. All right, moving on to number 4, IBM Data Science. This course has a 4.6 rating of over 60,000 people, and that's a very good score. It's a beginner level course and a 5 months at 10 hours per week, supposed to prepare you for a career in data science, like data scientist, junior data scientist, and data architect. Now, I personally think it's slightly misleading because if you don't have any experience or degree, It's going to be very tough to land a data scientist job after this course, if not absolutely impossible, but it can definitely help you start. So let's go through these courses really quick. First, we have an introduction to data science. You learn about all the tools, the methodology, and then get to working hands-on with Python for data science. You'll do a project with Python in course 4, which is a huge plus. Projects, they help you learn, but they're also really useful later when you look for jobs, since a portfolio and quality projects make you stand out from the competition. Then the next few courses are all about databases and SQL and data analysis with Python, data visualization. And as you can see, everything is about Python, and that's a very good thing because it's such a useful skill to learn. Finally, we have machine learning and a capstone project, so throwing in some other stuff as well. The pros and cons of this course is that Python is a huge plus. I also like the focus on projects and applying what you've learned. It's also a very general course, and that's a good thing, but it can also be a little bit of a bad thing. If you're looking for a specific thing, then maybe it's not the best course. Could be a course that's more specific and better for you, so consider the opportunity cost of taking this course. If there's a course that's better for you, you should definitely take that instead. Let's move on to number 5, Microsoft Power BI Data Analyst. I promise this is the last analytics course, but I just had to mention this one. This is a relatively new course where you learn the basics of data analyst skills, but really focus on Power BI, the visualization tool. 4.6 out of 5 rating, 5 months at 10 hours per week, and it's for beginners, of course. Course 1 is about preparing data with Excel, next an introduction to Power BI, and then ETL in Power BI, data modeling in Power BI, data analysis and Viz in Power BI, creating, designing, deploying, and maintaining assets, and a final capstone project. And in the last course, you will get the opportunity to prepare for the PL300 exam, which gets you Microsoft certified if you do decide to take it. The main benefit of this course is that it's directly by Microsoft, who owns Power BI, and it's going to help you prepare for the exam to get certified. The downside is that you'll definitely have to supplement it with other courses, for example on SQL or Python or something. It doesn't really cover those aspects, and it's a very niche course on Power BI, but still really useful if that's what you're looking to learn. All right, next up we have the machine learning course by Andrew, a very popular instructor with great teaching. I mean, look at the 4.9 review. It's for beginners looking to break into AI and machine learning, and a pretty short course at just 2 months, 10 hours of studying per week. It comes with 3 main courses: supervised machine learning, advanced learning, algorithms, and finally, unsupervised learning. For this one, it's more interesting to take a look at what you're going to learn. So you're going to build machine learning models and also train supervised models. You'll apply the best practices for ML development, as well as deal with unsupervised learning. You'll also build and train a neural network using TensorFlow, and you'll do a lot more stuff. The point of this course isn't to make you a machine learning expert or something, but rather give you a nice introduction to the field and many different areas of machine learning, and then you can continue from there. You will learn a ton. The certificate looks great as well because it says machine learning. So if you want to move more towards the field, it can be nice to have a cert for machine learning. There are many pros for this one. ML and AI skills are highly in demand. It's a top quality course approved by Stanford and one of their most famous teachers, and deep learning AI, and it's available in 8 different languages. Now, it's also really nice to, you know, break into a field that's generally difficult to grasp for a beginner, so I highly recommend this course. All right, let's move on to number 7. This one is slightly different, but I need to include this one because it's an untapped opportunity. The IBM Data Engineer Certificate is a pretty unknown program, to be honest. There are not that many students enrolled, only 8,000, but a 4.6 rating from these people, which is really, really good. And I think it's an untapped opportunity, to be honest. It's for beginners, no specific programming skills are required, and it only takes 5 months at 10 hours per week. Let's take a look at the courses. We have an introduction to the field first, next Python, and more specifically a course for data science. And this one was actually included in the other IBM program, like a few of these other courses, because the skills overlap. Like between a data scientist, a data analyst, data engineer, there are skills that overlap. Next, a Python project for data engineering, introduction to relational databases, and relational database management systems. Course 5 is about SQL and Python, then a Linux and shell course, a course about relational database administration, and a course about ETL and data pipelines, which are very, very important for a data engineer. Then we have some data warehousing and BI analytics, NoSQL databases, and finally some big data and machine learning. They are really throwing in a lot in this course, and finally a capstone project to top it all off. Now, what about the pros pros and cons about this course. I think it's a very comprehensive course, perhaps even a little bit too many things in this course, considering what you're going to be doing as a data engineer. You know, it doesn't cover the exact skills, but rather gives you a ton of stuff, and then kinda covers those skills as well. Data engineering is a very exciting field with many high-paying jobs available. And what I don't like is how they claim to get you job ready in less than 5 months with no prior experience as a data engineer. That's probably not going to be true. I haven't seen it myself. And from my research, it's very hard to land a data engineering role without experience or a degree. This seems like a little bit of a stretch, unfortunately, but still a very valuable course. All right, we're nearly there. But first, I want to talk about Python for Everybody. This course has over 1.5 million students enrolled, 4.8 stars in total, from over 200,000 people. Super popular course, had only 10 hours and 2 months to complete it, and the purpose of this course is to teach Python to absolute beginners. But then it gets more and more advanced and focuses on analyzing data with Python in the later courses. Course 1 is about programming and fundamentals. Next, data structures in Python, and then a practical course using Python to access web data. Finally, databases with Python, and a capstone project about retrieving, processing, and visualizing data with Python. I think it's a great course, a great teacher, Professor Shuck, and perfect for beginners looking to really build up their Python knowledge from scratch and focus on using Python to analyze data. What I will say though is that if you're going to be using this, I recommend combining it with like We3 Schools or something to give you more practice opportunities. I did take a part of this course and I kind of realized that it was a lot of videos and not as much practice as I would have liked to see, but the videos can be very helpful to give you that foundational knowledge that you don't necessarily get if you only practice. You also have to learn the theoretical parts. I'm going to leave a link to all the courses in the description, and if you're considering starting a course, I promise you that in the future you're going to thank yourself for starting today. That's all for this video. Have an amazing week, guys, and watch this video next.